चले कंटिन्यू। हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम वीरभद्र यदेमय फ्रॉम EVSM अकेडमी। ग्रामीण मक्कळिगागि विशेष तरगतिगळु बयालजी ट्रांसपिरेशन इज द लॉस ऑफ वाटर फ्रॉम अ प्लांट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ वाटर वेपर। वाटर इज अब्सॉर्ब्ड बाय रूट्स फ्रॉम द सॉइल एंड ट्रांसपोर्टेड एज अ लिक्विड टू द लीव्स वाया xylem. This process helps in exchange of gases, sending out excessively absorbed water. The absorption and the distribution of water in plants, providing coolness to the plant body, osmotic balance of the cell is maintained by transpiration. Well, friends, means of transport, that is by diffusion, plant water relations, water potential, osmosis, plasmolysis, imbibition is very important, long distance transport of water. The main parts of the plant is leaf, stem and root system. Shoot system, that is leaf and stem. Root system, roots. The leaf anatomy, opening and closing of stomata, apex, margin, veins, midrib, base, petiole and stipule. The anatomy of the plant is also important in the transportation in plants. This is leaf anatomy. We will discuss leaf anatomy well in detail. Stomata is an important organ in the leaf, which is bilar cell pent up manure appear osmosis taking place, carbon dioxide in and oxygen is out along with water vapor. Stomata are the cellular pores on the surface of plant leaves that we know. Classification of plant tissue, meristematic tissue and permanent tissue. Cell transport requires energy. Active transport in osmosis does not require energy, that is passive transport.
Hello. Hey. Yeah, is that pardon?
Means of transport, diffusion is very important here. The diffusion of molecules through xylem and phloem. Stomata. The stomata in the leaf, stoma, the pore in the leaf. So, my dear friends, facilitated diffusion, as pointed out earlier, a gradient must already be present for diffusion to occur. The diffusion rate depends on the size of the substances. Obviously, smaller substances diffuse faster. The diffusion of any substance across a membrane also depends on its solubility in lipids, the major constituent of the membrane. They do not set up concentration gradient. A concentration gradient must already be present for molecules to diffuse, even if facilitated by proteins. This process is called facilitated diffusion. This is the facilitated diffusion. Outer side of the cell membrane. And this is the transport protein, transport molecule, inner side of the cell. See, my dear, passive transport and antipodes, some carrier or transport proteins allow diffusion only if two types of molecules move together. And this is transportation in plants. Active transport uses energy to transport and pump molecules against a concentration gradient. Active transport is carried out by specific membrane proteins. Hence, different proteins in the membrane play a major role in both active as well as in passive transport. So, friends, transportation consists of active transport and passive transport. Pumps are proteins that use energy to carry some substances across the cell membrane. These pumps can transport substances from a low concentration to a high concentration. So here is important uphill transport. Transport rate reaches a maximum when all the protein transporters are being used or saturated. Like enzymes, the carrier protein is very specific in what it carries across the membrane. These proteins are sensitive to inhibitors that react with protein side chains. So here this is plasmolyzed water outside the membrane. Here placid water outside the membrane, and it is turgid water inside, enter into the membrane by. So here another important thing, symplast and apoplast. So this is the root system, plasmo, and the plasma membrane, epidermis, outermost layer of the root, cortex, then epidermis, then pericycle, which is nothing but xylem, the tissue. So this is very important, transporting plants. For further details, please contact VVSM Academy, 9663828428. For detail, contact Veerabhadraya Demaya, Farm House, Gopal.